we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section complex analysis, and this problem is on the differentiability of a given function. This problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020 and it is from the section B. The problem is, define f, a function from C, the set of complex numbers, to C by f of z is equal to mod of mod z square minus 1 whole square. Which of the following statements is true? The four options are given to us. Option 1, f is complex differentiable at all complex numbers except for z belongs to the set consisting of 0, 1. Option 2, f is complex differentiable only at z is equal to 0. Option 3, f is complex differentiable only at z is equal to 1. Option 4, f is complex differentiable only for z belongs to the set consisting of 0, 1. We now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. F is a function from C to C defined as f of z is equal to mod of mod z square minus 1 whole square. Now, f of z is equal to mod of mod z square minus 1 square is written as, for mod z square we have written z bar, and thereby we get mod of z bar minus 1 whole square. Note down that z bar is a real number, minus is a positive real number, and z bar minus 1 is a real number. Mod of that is a positive real number, and therefore I can write down this as z bar minus 1 whole square. Now, to discuss about the differentiability of this function fz, we must first of all know where the Cauchy-Riemann equations are valid. And at those points where Cauchy-Riemann equations are valid, we have to test the continuity of the continuity of the first order partial derivatives of u and v at the points where Cauchy-Riemann equations are valid. So first, let us discuss the Cauchy-Riemann equations are valid at what points we will discuss. Now, the complex equivalent of the Cauchy-Riemann equations is dou f by dou z bar is equal to 0. That is, if and only if, differentiate with respect to z bar, 2 into z bar minus 1, and the derivative of z bar minus 1 with respect to z bar is z. And this, if and only if z is equal to 0 and z bar minus 1 is equal to 0, this is if and only if z is equal to 0 and mod z is equal to 1. Thus, the Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied at the origin and at all points on the unit circle. Now, we have seen in case 1, the Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied at the origin and at all points on the unit circle. Now, f of z is equal to z bar minus 1 whole square is equal to z bar is x square plus y square minus 1 whole square is equal to u of x comma y plus I v of x comma y, and where u of x comma y is x square plus y square minus 1 whole square, v of x comma y is equal to 0, true for all x comma y. Now we just discuss the continuity of these first order partial derivatives ux, uy, vx, vy at the above points, that is at the origin and at all points on the unit circle. Now partial derivative of u with respect to x is 2 times x square plus y square minus 1 into 2x. The partial derivative of u with respect to y is 2 times x square plus y square minus 1 into 2y. And the partial derivative of v with respect to x is equal to the partial derivative of v with respect to y is equal to 0. And note down ux, uy, vx, vy, these are all polynomials in x and y, and hence they are continuous everywhere, and therefore they are continuous at the above points, namely at the origin and at all points on the unit circle. So combining the case, this Cauchy-Riemann equations and the continuity of the first order partial derivatives, we say from 1 and 2, the points at which f of z is complex differentiable are the origin and all points on the unit circle. That is, f is complex differentiable only for z belongs to S, where S is the set consisting of z such that z is equal to 0 or mod z is equal to 1. Now we summarize, that is the given function is differentiable at the origin at all points on the unit circle. Let's look at the options. The option 1 says f is complex differentiable at all complex numbers except for z belongs to 0 to 1 is not true. And option 2 is not true because it says it is differentiable only at z is equal to 0. Option 3 is also not true because it says differentiable only at z is equal to 1. And option 4 is also not true. So from this we make a remark. We notice that none of the options is true. To save the problem or to save this question, we modify the options as follows. So, option 1 is kept as it is and it is not true. Option 2 is kept as it is, it is not true. Option 3 is modified as it is complex differentiable only for mod z is equal to 1, and this is also not true because it's also differentiable at z is equal to 0. Option 4. F is complex differentiable only for z belongs to S, where S consisting of all those complex numbers z such that z is equal to 0 or mod z is equal to 1, and thereby option 4 will be true. So the answer is option 4 is true. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the complex analysis, which is based on the differentiability of the complex functions. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on these lines. I wish you all the best. Thank you.